Ammo and Attitude is back, and this time in the great state of Texas. All new challenges, all new contestants. Five women of action compete in a Lone Star Showdown with challenges that will push their skill and stamina to the max. Which one of these ladies will have what it takes to come out on top? On the next Ammo and Attitude.
She's on my mind every night and day. At the top of my list every time I pray. She don't need daddy's money. She makes it on her own. She ain't mama's little girl. Mama's girl's all gone. She's everything I want. Don't take long to see her point of view. She's got ammo and attitude. Stalk it, kill it, clean it, and grill it. There ain't nothing she can't do. Dress her in camo with a little bit of ammo and a whole lot of attitude. She's got ammo and attitude. On
the last Ammo and Attitude, the ladies found themselves jumping out of a Nissan Titan and racing to find a hidden neon softball. Our host, Tennille, sat above a pool of Texas swamp water as the contestants took aim. However, she made it through the day dry as a bone. Judy Lamb won the challenge with the fastest time, receiving her first victory of the competition. Welcome to day 3 of Ammo and Attitude.
Hello, ladies, and welcome to the London Bridge and Lollipops Challenge. Let's hear from our announcer to see what today's activity entails.
Thank you, Tennille. Today's challenge starts with a sprint to the shooting rail, where they must load and shoot a Glock 9, hitting all the lollipop targets, or until out of ammunition. Once the targets have been completed, it's a lengthy dash to an elevated platform, where the ladies are allowed 3 attempts, taking aim at a Tannerite target 100 yards away, using an Armalite rifle outfitted with a Vortex scope. The course is a difficult one and will not only test their marksmanship, but also their stamina. Good luck, ladies.
The first competitor today will be the winner of yesterday's challenge. Judy, you won the challenge. You're up first. Let's get ready. Ladies, if you'd please exit and take a seat.
Ammo and Attitude is brought to you in part by Nissan's American Titan Truck, G-Shock, Armalite, Glock, and Tannerite. Ammo and Attitude is brought to you in part by Surgeon Rifles, McMillan, Vortex, and Tough Products. Introducing the Z-Print Run by Reebok. Designed around a 3D map of the human foot for better cushioning, foot stride flexibility, and stable foot tracking, the low-cut, smooth-fit design makes for better ankle mobility and easy movement. And the new Reebok CrossFit Nano 5.0 is the lightest, strongest, and most innovative nano yet made. The 3D print cage mimics DuraWeb construction, providing upper and lateral support and stability. I'm real, and I'm Reebok. First up is Judy Lamb with Team G-Shock.
Judy, are you ready?
Yes.
Stand by.
Thank you.
Unload and show clear. Lock the bolt back, please. Thank you. Perfect. Go ahead and lay it down. Hey, can you hand me that magazine, please? Thank you. Tuck feet.
Next up is Bobby Hedegaard with Team Tannerite.
Bobby, are you ready? Stand by. Unload and show clear. Okay, gun's clear. Lock the bolt back, please. Perfect. Would you hand me the magazine, please? Thank you. Nice job.
Next up is Pinky Pinkerson with Team Block.
Pinky, are you ready?
I'm ready.
Stand by. Lay down, and if you'd hand me the magazine, please. That's one way to do it. Thank you.
Next up is Sarah Thomas with Team McMillan.
Sarah, are you ready?
I am.
Stand by. Unload and show clear. Bolts locked back. Great, go ahead and lay it down, please. Hand me the magazine. Excellent, thank you.
Next up is Katrina Reed with Team Nissan.
Great, lock the bolt back. And hand me the magazine, please. Thank you. Great job today, ladies. Let's head back to Campfire Armory and check out the results.
Ammo and Attitude is brought to you in part by Polaris Fun Center, Slingshot, Wiley X, TruSpec, and Reebok. Ammo and Attitude is brought to you in part by Champion Firearms, Revy, ProShot, and Total Resources. ProShot Products. Our family heritage and passion for the shooting sports has been passed down through the generations. For 35 years, we've added quality products to our line so that we now have a complete line of firearms cleaning supplies and splattershot targets. Our quality cleaning rods and accessories are made of steel and brass, not plastic. This makes cleaning faster and easier. Firearm cleaning products and splattershot targets are all made in the USA. That's ProShot Products.
Hello, ladies, and welcome to Campfire Armory. Let's go over today's challenge. How do you like shooting at Tannery targets?
Love a Tannery.
Well, we're really fortunate to have them as a sponsor this year.
Absolutely.
Sarah, you smoke through that pistol. How do you feel about that Glock 9?
I liked it, very smooth. I'm getting to be a little more familiar with it, and it was a lot of fun shooting that course.
Excellent. And Judy, tell me what your strategy is for this competition.
To make it to the end.
Anything else?
To make it to the end.
All right, fair enough. Bobby, what did you think about that Armalite rifle?
I love that gun. It shoots very well. It was nice, smooth, crisp trigger on it, and I liked the scope on it as well.
Excellent. Well, today's challenge did have one very clear winner, and she smoked through the pistol, as I mentioned. Sarah, today you are the winner of today's bullet.
Thank you. Way to go, girl.
Congratulations.
Thank you.
Our Attitude Bullet will also be presented today, and it's one of my favorite to award. This is going to a competitor who struggled a little bit with some issues on the rifle, but continued to work through them, didn't even blink an eye, and I thought that showed a lot of fortitude with her as a person. Pinky, today's Attitude Bullet goes to you.
Thank you.
Good job.
Well, let's head back to camp and get some rest, because tomorrow we're going to find out who is the fittest of them all.
Ammo and Attitude is brought to you in part by Metal Spinning Targets, Cinch, and Cruel Girl, Fat Man Beef Jerky, and Airsoft. Ammo and Attitude is brought to you in part by Promatic, Dripping Springs Vodka, Fall Creek Vineyards, Rebecca Creek Distillery, the Museum of the American GI.
Wow, today we shot a two-gun style course of fire, which was kind of cool. I have to admit, I enjoy those types of competitions. So, same Glock pistol that we used before, which was shot very nicely. I enjoyed shooting that. And we shot the Armalite rifle, which was very nice. Had not shot that before, so I definitely enjoyed that. And I really enjoyed the Vortex scope that was on it, too. I'm definitely going to be looking into that for personal use after this. Today, I felt like I did pretty good. I didn't clean the pistol as fast as I wanted to, the pistol targets, but still not too bad. I got them all knocked down with the, you know, less than the amount of rounds that we had available to us, which was good. I think I ran pretty good between stations, and I was a little disappointed on the rifle target. I really wanted to blow up that Tannerite, but it just wasn't meant to be today. I have no idea. I hear some talk about some physical activity, a physical challenge. I don't know. We'll see.
We had a two-gun competition where we shot a Glock at some steel targets and then climbed up on this bridge, they called it London Bridge, and shot a rifle at some Tannerite. Not very well, not as good as I know I could have. So I think nerves just got the best of me, but just work through it and move on and keep trucking along. I won the Best Attitude Award basically for just keeping going and working through the issues I had with the gun and not giving up. You know, I'm disappointed because I know I could have shot better, but I just, as far as like just putting in as much effort as I can, I tried to make up my time on the run and then trying to get control of my breathing when I was shooting the Tannerite. I heard something about let's see who the fittest is, so I'm saying there's probably going to be some CrossFit involved. So I'm a little nervous about that too.
Today I shot London Bridge and Lollipops. Very subpar performance for me. I'm disappointed, but I'm going to trust the process. I'm going to rebound. So far, so good. Just stay away from the holes. would have slowed down on my pistol, made those shots count, zeroed, put the scope on one power on the rifle. The pistol is my weak point. I don't know, but I'm super excited. I'm going to rebound and come back, and I'm going to trust the process with some attitude.
Today we did a pistol challenge and also rifle. Today was not so good for me. I struggled with the pistol. Once again, I don't know why. I mean, the Glock shot great. It's not the gun. It was me. And then we went and did some shooting at Tannerite with the rifle, and just no luck with that. My shooting on the pistol, I'm not sure. I think it was probably a little of the nerves. On the rifle, I'm really not sure on that one either. I felt like I had a good target. The scope was amazing, and I felt pretty confident in my shot, so I must have just pulled a little bit. My overall performance, I'm not happy with myself, but I still feel like I'm middle of the road. I still have a chance. I'm not getting down. I'm just going to take my mistakes and go from there and just improve the rest of the time. Next challenge, I think it's going to be CrossFit, so I'm not sure I'm looking forward to it. I'm looking forward to see what it is, but we'll see. I'm not sure how strong I'll be in that area, but I'll try.
Today we got to do a little bit of free gun action, shooting some metal plates. It was my first time running and gunning the way that we did, and I had a lot of fun. I got to work with the Glock a little bit more, which I enjoyed. I felt that I did pretty good with the metal plates. Would like to have done a little bit better with that rifle. Would like to close some stuff up, but it was fun. It was a nice rifle, really nice scope, and it was all around fun. Can't complain, I'm shooting. I did. I actually did win today. I'm very happy about that. It was a lot of fun, and I have fun with all the girls. Every single day, everything we do is a lot of fun, so I just look forward to doing more things. Tomorrow's challenge, it sounds like we're going to be getting a little sweaty, which I'm okay with, and we'll see how I do, see how long I last.
On the next Ammo and Attitude, kettlebell swings, huge tractor tires, barbells, burpees, crawling under a rope, Tannerite, and lots of ammo. The Reebok Challenge will be the toughest yet. Which one of our contestants will have what it takes to rise above the rest in the Texas heat? Make sure not to miss the next episode of Ammo and Attitude.
Another fantastic Shipman Agency production.